Hello, everyone, and welcome. Welcome to this informal session of the Moodle MOOC. This is the Moodle part, and it's going to be quite short today, so I'm not going to keep you. If you could add me, add in the chat box where you're from, and whether it's morning, noon, or night. Okay, so it's nighttime in Kiev, I guess. And wow, we've got Kelowna, BC, Canada. I only know the name because my daughter is a triathlon coach, and I think she has, they have some competitions there in triathlon. That's the first time I heard of it. And Maria from Ecuador. All right, so we're going to get started. Harriet is also from the States. Let's see. Oh, wow. We've got Lampur, and it's afternoon. We've got afternoon, evening. Okay, I just want you to notice that you'll get a badge for attending this live session. There's the link to the badge in the chat box, and there's also the code, so you just click on it. And it'll take you, just to give you a visual here, what you do is you click on that, and, oh, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. Good morning. Wow, that's great. I like mornings. So this is the link to Connected Educators. This is Connected Educators Month, and it's organized by the State Department of Education, the United States. So you just go into this link that I added in the chat box. You click on Have a Claim, and then you add the link. It's MIES336. Just copy and paste it. You'll be able to copy the chat at the end. All right, so these sessions on Moodle are for those of you that are interested in Moodle 2.5, whether you're experienced or whether you're very, very new to Moodle. A little bit about myself. I've been Moodling since 2003. I started my first Moodle, but I was made an administrator. So I plunged right in from the very beginning. So it's been 10 wonderful years. You can read a little bit about me. You can also find me online. I am very, very involved in Moodle. I teach. I've been teaching using Moodle in, I guess, mostly blended, which means that I teach face-to-face and I use Moodle for the online part. As someone said, I think Jason R. Levine mentioned, he can't see himself teaching face-to-face without the online element. And I think that's so true today. I also find that it's impossible just to stand in front of a physical classroom and talk. I need to use information and share information and bring my students out of the classroom and into the internet, where there's so much information, both visual, auditory, and through videos. So I don't know how anyone can teach without technology, but that's me. You know, my colleagues are doing fine teaching without technology. Their students are completely bored, but, you know, they're on their cell phones or their laptops, iPads. They're using technology in the classroom, but they're not connected to one another and very disconnected from their teachers. So I'm just going through some of my bio so you can get a glimpse of that. And my motto is teach to learn. and learn to teach, and teaching as a way to learn. All right, so we're going to go straight into week three. I don't know how many of you are following the Moodle for non-beginners and Moodle for beginners. If you can add in the chat box whether you are, so give me a thumbs up or NB, Moodle for teachers NB, if that's the course you're in, or Moodle for teachers N, a beginner, sorry. Or if you are not, just give me a thumbs down and I'll know that you're not in any of the Moodle courses. For those of you that are not and that are interested in joining, the link is moodleforteachers.org. Okay, that's it. All right, good to see you, Ichi. All right. So people are really busy, but they're taking the time to come. And I think that's really exciting. And I feel very, very cared for. So thank you very much for coming to these live sessions on Moodle. As you know, the Moodle MOOC is also about transpersonal development and not just educators as teachers, but educators as people and leaders. All right. So week three is about challenges and best practices. Most of you have added quite a bit of information, hello Guadalupe, about the challenges. I didn't see so much about best practices, but you're going to be doing it in week three. First of all, as a teacher, okay? And you'll be thinking about yourself as a teacher. What would you like to see in Moodle as a teacher? Whether you teach face-to-face and you want to add the online element to turn it into blended, or whether you teach fully online. As a teacher, what would you like Moodle to do for you? Okay, this is something that you'll be thinking about. Hello, Joe. Use Moodle, but not in Moodle for Teachers. All right, so you might want to join. There are two courses. One course, it's about Moodle 2.5, if you're not familiar. If you are, that's okay. So there's Moodle for beginners and Moodle for non-beginners. Non-beginners are a lot of administrators, and it's a chance to connect and learn together. Okay, so first of all, as a teacher, and then as a participant. I don't like to call my students students. I like to call them participants, because I feel that, I think teachers are participants too, because I feel that we take part in learning together. So as participants, what would you like your participants to do with Moodle? That's great, Joe, since 1999, but not Moodle, because Moodle started in 2001. Actually, it was up in 2002. Yes, WebCT. Okay, so again, what would you like your participants to do with Moodle? Okay, I find that we don't think about this, but it's something that I think would benefit all of us if we could think of how we would like to use Moodle as teachers, and how would we like our students to use it. So Courtney says, I would like my students to use Moodle to, excellent, to have conversations with peers. And learn, of course. Okay. But when I say do, we're talking specifically about activities. Okay. And we'll be going through the activities. But before we go into the specific activities that we have on Moodle, I think it would benefit us all if we could think about ourselves and our students. Also, I would like my students to use Moodle as a resource to navigate their course and to receive. Of course. Yes, we want them to go somewhere. Whatever we're teaching, we want them to succeed, whether it's to pass an exam or to get a degree or to write a great paper or a dissertation. Okay, we also want them to reach a certain level, whatever it happens to be. Okay, so of course the grade is part of it. Okay, next. How are you going to do it? Well, this is how we are doing it in the Moodle for Teachers, for non-beginners, and for beginners. And this is how I do it. I discuss, okay, and the students discuss. Everybody has a discussion. Okay, so it's done through the discussion. Some of you mentioned conversations. So we talk about things and then we practice. Okay, if we're talking about Moodle for Teachers, you get a chance to practice, and the practice area is Moodle. There is a place to practice, whether you're new or you're not new. It's the Moodle practice area. So if you're not new, it's a chance for the veteran Moodlers to model how they use Moodle for the newcomers. So practice, once you discuss the topic, to practice to do something with it, and then of course to teach others as a way to learn. Okay, Joe mentioned a U-shaped discussion. Well, that's how I like to have my students sit. But okay, U-shaped discussion, which means that it's not a circle. You don't go around in circles, but you have a starting point, and it's parallel to your end point. Is that what you mean? There's a beginning. Okay, excellent. All right. So we're going to go through Moodle activities and look at the challenges. And when I say challenges, some people would call it confusion. But it's not that point. It's not the confusion. It's whatever seems to stand in the way. And we have this all the time. I mean, things don't go smoothly. One of the things that I find wonderful about Moodle is the fact that I can have a very, very skeleton kind of plan of what I'm going to do with my students, but I can also change things. And I think Dave Cormier also mentioned that that's how he does it too. And I was kind of surprised because I don't usually share this with my colleagues and my administrator because they want us to plan everything at least half a year in advance. And I find that impossible because I don't know, the students. And until I get to know the students and I know exactly where they're coming from, it's very hard for me to try to teach a theoretical course to theoretical students. Okay, I can't do, I mean, I could do that, but I find it very dry and almost impossible. So I find myself changing things all the time. And those of you who have been to my courses, I think Thomas must have noticed it. Or maybe you didn't notice it, but I'm constantly changing, I'm adding things. I don't usually delete anything, but I'm always adding things to the courses as I learn about my students and what they need. So Moodle is perfect for me. So one of the challenges that I find is not being able to know or predict what my students will need. I can't. So Moodle really caters to how I do things because I am able to make changes. Now, if you're using a textbook and you're stuck because you can't go around changing the textbook, but if you're using Moodle, you can always add new resources, make changes according to what your students need. Next are best practices. Now, best practices are probably the hardest things to document and reflect on. We tend to remember the challenges and put aside best practices and forget about showing appreciation for the good things that we do. How many of you can remember the wonderful, wonderful course design that you had? Exactly. What is the best practice? Well, it's not one best practice, but it's a few best practices. What worked for you? For you and your students, of course, but what did you succeed and you were very happy with? It could be even aha moments. I think Ludmilla mentioned a lot of these aha moments. I think Cheryl Nussbaum Beach also mentioned it. Dr. Ludmilla Smirnova mentioned the fact that the best practices is when you get the aha moments from your students. And of course, that's when you feel that you've done things right. Yes, our courses change all the time because there's no such thing. I mean, there are textbooks and textbooks don't change. But when you're teaching online, things, you allow things to change. That's right, Joe. No, never. It's never alike. And that's why, for me, it's exciting. All right, so we're going to look at Moodle activities. Okay, that's what it's about today. What activities are you familiar with or happy with? Okay, if you could just write down maybe some of the activities and then we'll get into the specific ones. Yeah, you know what, Joe, that reminds me. You can take my courses, my online courses, you know, every year and it'll be completely different. So Maria says forum, quizzes, what's that, Flipgrid? I think that's gone. You mean the light bulb? WizIQ is also an activity. It's part of the activity. It's not a resource. Yeah, it is. It's considered an activity. How many people find an activity very, very challenging? I've heard people say workshop. They can't figure out how to use the workshop. Or they found, what else? Some may find quizzes difficult. Because don't forget, you have to design them. It takes a lot of time. Yeah. Well, you'll have a chance to use all of these. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the activities. For those of you who are interested, well, this is a chance, Harriet, to try it out with everybody. Because when you have your own course, you're by yourself. And I think that's a very lonely place to have a course and not to have other teachers in there. So in the Moodle practice area, it's not only about WizIQ the way it was in Moodle MOOC 1, but in Moodle MOOC 2 and in Moodle MOOC 3 and the coming MOOCs, Moodle MOOCs, the Moodle practice area is a place where you can do anything you want. In other words, try out the activities, Moodle activities, and the resources. Resources are limited. So the first thing you do when you go to the Moodle practice area, if you could add, it's called MPA. I'll go there later on, but if someone has the link close by, you may add it to the chat box. Good to see you, John Davey. I'm just wondering the time. I'm trying to get the right time for Australia, New Zealand, Thailand, some of the other countries in the area, Singapore. But I'm not sure whether I'm managing all right. So good to see you here. Oh, wonderful. I did it. Okay. I succeeded after, I don't know how many years, after 6 years, 6, 7 years, I think. Okay, great. So this is a good time. I'm glad. All right. I'm trying. All right. So you turn editing on. The first thing you do when you go into a course where you have editing rights, that's teacher with editing rights or course creator, of course, managers, you also need to turn it on. In some cases, administrators also need to turn it on, depending on the course. But you'll have to turn editing on. That's at the, well, where is turn editing on? Why don't you tell me in the chat box, where is turn editing on? Thank you, Maria. That's right. Okay, it's the top right. Next, you'll see two things. You'll see topic. If you are a manager, course creator, or administrator, you will see this icon. The icon indicates that, well, you tell me, what does number one icon indicate? Very good. Wonderful. That's right. Thank you, Lilia. That's right. It usually says settings, but the idea is edit. So both Thomas and Leah are right. So how can two people be right when they give two different answers? Well, you'll learn about that tomorrow with quantum physics and our transpersonal development presentations. Tomorrow's presentation is going to be awesome. The speaker is one of the scientists who spoke at the What the Bleep down the rabbit hole. All right, so this is settings, and it's a chance to edit. You click on it, it gives, allows you to edit. But you won't see it, okay? You'll only see this. This means that you can move things, okay? And change their positions. What is important for all of you is to look at this. How many of you are not using 2.4 or 2.5? Not. Or have not seen 2.4 or 5? Okay, give me a thumbs up if you have not seen this. Add an activity or resource. If you're new to Moodle, you haven't seen this, so you could also put thumbs down. Okay, so Joe, what version of Moodle have you used? Well, you're not sure. All right, so this is Moodle 2.5 point, I think, 0.1. But it's Moodle 2.5. I think this started in Moodle 2.4. That means that the activities and resources are now under one link. Remember, brownish red is clickable. So you click here. 2.3 doesn't have it, I don't think. But it's great. If you're not using 2.5, you have no idea what you're missing. And that's an understatement, because I am the administrator of a few Moodles, and Atlantic University, where I'm the administrator, has 2.4, and it drives me crazy, absolutely crazy. Once you are in 2.5, you don't want to go back. I remember when I was stuck in 1.9, I thought that was the greatest invention. Well, 2.2 wasn't bad, but 2.5 is just amazing. It's faster. That's one good thing about it. All right, so this is where you click. Okay, you click on this brownish red. On my site, okay, it could be any other color on another site, but it's clickable. Notice the light bulb and the eye. What is the eye? Why is this eye here? Okay, that's great, Ichi. You're gonna love it. Yes, Thomas, when I went into 2.0, I missed 1.9, but now with 2.5, I can't look back. No. Anybody else guess what this I means? To view or not to view. I guess we mean the same thing. If you can either hide or unhide. If you hide this, the students will not be able to see it. But if you leave it open, they will be able to see it. I think everybody meant the same thing. So you're all right. Okay, so this is what it looks like on Moodle 2.5. Okay, so those of you who have not seen Moodle 2.5 may find this a bit different. So you will have a chance to practice each of these activities. Now notice on the left, you've got the activities. You click on, you check the circles, one of them at a time. And then at the bottom, it'll say save. On the right, you'll have the explanations, lots of explanations. Yes, Maria, exactly, open or hide. That's exactly what the eye is. Very good. Now, what you're going to do in week three, you're going to go through each one of these. So notice what you've got here. It goes according to alphabetical order. So the first one is assignment, advanced, and the different kinds of assignments. After assignments is the certificate. Yes, the certificate does not come with Moodle. It's a plugin or a module that I added, but it doesn't come with a raw Moodle. Next, you'll find the chat checklist, which doesn't come with Moodle, I also added it. Choice, database, external tool, feedback, forum, and there are five of them. Glossary, lesson. Notice the lesson is an activity. Mind map, quiz, SCORM package, survey, wiki. WizIQ, Maria said, or was it Harriet, that it's an activity, I think Harriet. And workshop. Okay, as I said, it's in alphabetical order. You are going to go through each one of these in week three. Isn't that fun? And you'll have a chance to discuss, practice, and teach. Okay, that's what you're going to be doing. Talk, you're going to discuss it, practice it, and teach it to others. And those of you who know me, I know exactly what I mean by teaching. Ah, that's why you're there. Okay, but you're still smart. All right, so let's take a look at just explanations. As I said, there's lots of explanations, more than you would probably need. So it explains what forums are used for. So forums have many uses, such as a social space for students to get to know each other. I'd like you to think of which one you like best. So we'll call it number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the first one is a social space for students to get to know one another. So that's S. Okay, call that S. For course announcements, using a news forum and forced subscription, but it doesn't have to be forced, especially if you have thousands of students, like in a MOOC. For discussing course content or reading material. For continuing online, an issue raised previously in a face-to-face session. Okay, this is more the blended idea. And for teacher-only discussions, using a hidden forum. Okay, so which one do you like? So I see three, three. Three seems to win. One, two, three. Course content or reading material? One, social space for discussing interesting themes, both. Well, of course, the first one happens once, okay? The second one is necessary, but it's not interactive. The news form doesn't allow your students, unless you give them permission. You can give students permission, and then they can also reply, respond, but generally they don't respond to it, so it's very static. Okay, Joe likes all of them. But it goes on. I told you more explanation than you expect. It goes on. A help center where tutors and students can give advice. That's another way to use a discussion form if you didn't think of it. You see, Moodle was created with interactivity in mind. And apparently, it turned out that many teachers, you probably know them, were using Moodle as a storage room or a library, I don't know what you'd call it, a place to for resources only. And they were not using the discussion forums. So Martin Dogiama says, "This is ridiculous. I'm giving you all these discussion forms and you're not using them." So that's why he has all these explanations. It's also a one-on-one support area for private student-teacher communications. So you can have the groups, separate groups, and have a one-to-one discussions with your students. And finally, for extension activities, for example, brain teasers for students to ponder and suggest solutions to. Lots of reasons to use a discussion forum. And there are five of them. How many of you used all five? Give me a thumbs up if you used all five. All five of these discussion forums. Anyone? All five? Yes, you're right, Maria. Interactivity is super important. I would fall asleep, and so would my students if they weren't engaged. Oh, Maria, you've used all of them. That's great, Courtney. You can go into the smiley, by the way, and you can get a thumbs up too. They're free. But they're one color. I think it's time they also put them in different colors. But right now, you can change the font, but you can't change the color of the smileys. There's a single to simple discussion and everyone can reply to, but you cannot use it with separate groups. Each person posts one discussion, each student can post exactly one. Okay, depending on the purpose, Q&A forum, standard format, blog-like, which I love. Okay, and there's also the standard forum. So which one do you like? By the way, Sloodle is no longer part of Moodle, unfortunately. The standard, yeah, most of us. But I like, Thomas, try the blog-like format. It looks nice. But you know what? We're creatures of habit, and you're going to hear about that from Stephen Downs, the fact that we are, and from others tomorrow too, from Dr. Dean Radden. We're creatures of habit, and we tend to stick to, including me, of course. I mean, you know, I'm also a creature of habit. You can add videos. You can create one there. There's Kaltura that is compatible with Moodle that you can add. It's a collaborative video. I don't know if you've heard of Kaltura. Kaltura. They were supposed to present at this MOOC, but they will be presenting at the next MOOC in February. You can Google it. You can also contact me if you want more information. I'm pretty close to them, to the organizers, and I used to use it on Wiki Educator quite a bit. It's quite nice. Used to be completely free. Now they have a free and a another one that they charge for. All right. So let's get to week three. What you're going to do is you're going to go into each of the activities in the Moodle practice area, and you're going to divide the activities and think about them as a teacher, as a participant. And think of the challenges. You can break that down into also challenges, best practices, teacher, participant. You can also ask each other. Okay, don't forget you're going to be working and discussing this before you practice. So discuss, practice, and teach. So first you have a chance to discuss some of the challenges. Some of you have started already. Best practices, divide each activity into participants and teachers, challenges and best practices. How are you with tables? How many of you like tables? I can tell you that I love them. I just love tables. What about you guys? Do you like tables? Yeah. Okay, great. So you can actually do this. Okay, Thomas is not. All right, you can actually do this on a Word document or on Google Drive, downloaded as a Word document, and then you can add it or paste it if you like in the Moodle course, not course, but discussion form. So Courtney is not a big fan. Maria, are you telling Maria? I mean, is Maria talking to Maria? Try it. Try it. It should work, Thomas. I know you've mentioned that as a challenge, but try it. And that's it? Okay, that's not it. Now we're going to screen share. Okay, I'm going to take you for a little drive. Are you ready for a drive? While I'm taking you there, my system will freeze. Okay, so I'd like to thank you for this part of the presentation and take you to the screen sharing part. As I screen share, you may find that things shift the way they do on a plane during the flight. So they may shift to the bottom left-hand side of the screen. Just pop them up, just pick them up and throw them back to the right or to the center, wherever you want to be. The WizIQ classroom is modular, which means that you have pretty much, well, a lot of control here, in fact. All right, so let me go into, first of all, the Moodle. Okay, so this is the Moodle for teachers. Okay, these are some of the challenges in the Moodle for non-beginners. There was quite a discussion here about scrolling and different things, but I want you to consider the challenges from the perspective of a teacher and a participant. So you're going to have to put yourself in the shoes of a student or a participant and not just the teacher. Okay, which means you're going to try to observe. And if you can do it without, too much judgment, just observe how things are, I find that it's more beneficial. I find that when I complain, I get blinded. You know, if I say, oh, no, this doesn't work, this is no good. That I don't really get much out of it. But when I try to view things without really coming to any conclusion, just looking at it and seeing it as a challenge, then things improve. I'm finding that my system is very slow right now. Don't know why. Extremely slow. In fact, it's not moving. So while I'm waiting for that, let me take you to the course. I'd like to talk about the course. Okay, this is Moodle, the Moodle MOOC on WizIQ. I know a lot of participants, not only of this MOOC, but in general, my students too, are fine with being on Facebook. But the minute we go somewhere else, they keep wondering, why do we have to leave this area and go into another area? I feel comfortable here. You know, it's like going to a house and you're in the living room and then the host says, okay, let's go upstairs or let's go to the garden. You know, sometimes it's nice and sometimes you feel like, why should I go to another room? I'm comfortable here. So it's the same kind of thing. We don't like to move when we're comfortable from one area to another. And I think this is something that will probably change in the future. I think we'll be more willing to move even when we're comfortable. But the challenge is there. So this is the Moodle MOOC on WizIQ. There are benefits to having an area where you can get the information out of the Moodle. Okay, and see how that fits in with you and how you feel about that, and try to see why, you know, what makes it difficult for you to move from one place to another. All right, so there are three areas: the courseware, where you get all the tutorials, and the classes. Classes are live classes. Notice you also have the tutorials. If you click on the tutorials, you get all the tutorials. Okay, for all the presentations, the live presentations. Okay, and notice there are YouTube videos as well. The classes are both upcoming classes and past classes. So the first opening class was on September 28. I've arranged it. I can move this. As you can see, I can delete and I can move this, but I'm not going to move it right now. And the classes. Notice October 5th. If you want to get a certificate, you have to reflect on 10 of the classes. Altogether, there are, I believe, 18. Okay, so there's, these have already taken place. Okay, this is today's class. And notice tomorrow we've got, and I'm going to share the movie. You're going to see the movie in the tutorial. It's on YouTube. It's over 2 hours. It's called What the Bleep? Down the Rabbit Hole. And one of the key scientists from the movie is Dr. Dean. Actually, he's Professor Dean Radden. Okay, and he's going to be talking about supernormal from a scientific perspective. It's about quantum physics and about, I think what's happening now and what's going to happen in the future. Apparently, reality is not what we used to think it is. It's what it is. And then, of course, there's blended technologies. Okay, all these sessions, you can go through them yourself. Okay, and of course, the last session wrapping up is on October 31st. If you can't make it, you can view the recordings. You can also get badges, and the codes will appear in each of these sessions. So even if you're viewing the recording, you'll be able to get the badge. In addition, there's a course feed. Okay, here's a live class. You can start a discussion based on these, on the tutorials, and on the live sessions. You can also introduce yourself and so on. You can also connect with the other learners, okay, course learners. And if you've forgotten what the course is about, if for any reason you want to leave the course, you go to the top right, and where it says course settings for me, it'll say leave the course. Okay, so that's also an option. We're also going to continue this area for Moodle, for the rest of the Moodle, for Moodle 3, Moodle MOOC 3. There will be three Moodle MOOCs a year. Let's see if this is open here. Oh, it's still stuck. Interesting. There'll be three Moodle MOOCs a year. Okay, one in June, October, and in February. Okay, let's see why it's stuck here. Oh. Let's try it again. Maybe I've been timed out. Okay, here we are. All right, I wanted to show you, this is the moodleforteachers.org. I wanted to show you that if you scroll down, I'm in as admin. Maybe I should not be as admin, so let me log out. Okay, so you'll see the Moodle for Beginners. And this is going back to the WizIQ course. This is the practice area, the Moodle practice area, and then Moodle for non-beginners. So if I go into the Moodle for practice area, okay, I have to log in. I have no choice. Okay, now it's going much faster. There are videos here on WizIQ. You can ignore them. There's also a free membership if you're interested. If you're an educator, you can get a free membership as a teacher on WizIQ. Okay, there is more information about that. And then you're going to, let me turn editing on. Remember, that's the first thing we do. Even as admin, I need to turn editing on. Okay, and then notice what happens. Okay, there are lots of editing. What you need to do here is take a topic. Oh, I like this one, Peter, very nice. And okay, so just grab a section. You will not see this. Okay, this is me as as admin. But if you go in, you'll be able to go straight into, write your name, but you'll go straight into this part, add an activity, then go into label. Add the label, it's not save. Add. Here you have explanations. If you want more, they send you to Moodle MOOC, moodle.org. You click on add label. Label is a resource. And then you'll add your name. So if your name is Ben, I don't think we have a Ben, you can save that. You can also make it nicer by going into show. Okay, because look, Ben is really tiny now. There's Ben. He's kind of small, right? So I can go, notice this moves things. Okay, it's a lot of fun moving it. But I'm going to go into this. Somebody called it setting. It says update. I want to make it a little bit larger and fix it up. So I'm going to go into show editing tools. Okay, and this opens up. And then over here it says toggle full screen to make it larger. And then I'm going to make Ben, let's see, I'll make it larger first of all. I'll go into paragraph and I'll make it heading one. And then I'll color it. Here, let's get a color that I usually like. Yeah. Okay, this one. Okay, that one. That's been. And then I have to go back into toggle. You can also put a video, image, and so on. Play around with the editor. And then once it's there, it's hard to see, I'll save and return to the course so that you can now see I was in topic. By the way, we can add the topic. I was in topic. Here we go. There's Ben. Okay. So you take a section by going into add an activity, module, a label, and then add your name. In addition, notice these are all activities that you're going to play around with in week 3. All right, so let's see if there are any questions. Let me go back to here. I hope nothing's shifted while I was screen sharing. And here we go. I didn't see your name, Maria. Are there any questions? Well, you can ask the questions in the course, whether you're in the non-beginners or in the beginners course. Feel free to ask questions. There are a lot of places for questions. If you'd like the mic, that's also an option, or you can just write your question. Maria says it was in MOOC. No, it's a different one, Maria. It's a completely different course. It's not the same. All right. So notice, copy the chat. And the reason is, let me give you the code again. Okay, and the link to the badge for those of you that were here. Okay, there's the link. Oops, trying to get the link in there. Okay, there's the link to the badge area. And let me get the code for you. There's the code. Whoops. Okay, there's the code. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, okay, if you don't know what I'm talking about, let me show you the whiteboard. There it is. Okay, so what you do is you go into that link, you click on the link. Why don't you do it now and let me know if it worked? You go into the link. You click on have a claim code. You paste the code. Thomas has it. Very good. And then you can share it. You can collect these so that by the end of the MOOC, you'll have a collection of. And it's nice because it's Connected Educators Month. All right, so I'd like to thank everybody and see you tomorrow. I wanted to share I will be sharing the YouTube video. So please go into the WizIQ course area. Let me share that with you. Also, you might want to go into the syllabus. Okay, so here is the syllabus for the MOOC. Okay, there it's in green. Okay, there's a syllabus, and here is the link, because all the tutorials, resources, whatever you want to call them, the content is going to be on WizIQ in the course area. So go there. And I hope you get a chance to watch the movie. It's called What the Bleep Down the Rabbit Hole. Anybody have it handy? And Dean is there. So let's see, down What the Bleep. I'll find it for you. What the Bleep. It's on YouTube. But it's only one of them. I think one of them is really good. Not all of them are I'm going to share the best one. This is the one that you can watch, and the reason that's why I'm sharing it with you.
Than what I think to be real, which seems now more to be unreal.
Share it with you. There we go. That's the best one because you can watch it in high definition, full screen.
Hi.
Okay, that's the one. So that's what's a bleep. And
Mazel.
you'll hear and see our speaker tomorrow. Our speaker for tomorrow is a very, very influential person in the world today, and that's Dr. Dean Radden. Has anybody heard of him? Amazing, an amazing scientist and psychologist. You've got a combination of both, who also practices yoga. And he's going to be talking about quantum physics and a lot about what he mentions in What the Bleep. If you go into YouTube, you also find a lot of other interviews by him. He was on Google. He presented on Google. You know, Google used to have these, maybe they still have them, presenters come and speak. He was one of the speakers. All right, so thank you, everyone. Thank you for coming. And I'm looking forward to seeing your work. And seeing you tomorrow. Bye for now. Thank you. This will be, of course, on YouTube. Your names will not appear. You'll just see and hear me. Thank you. Oh, by the way, add your feedback because that way, if you lose your code, I'll be able to share it with you.